I was like, damn, bizarch. Like, what do you mean?
How do you know? How do you know that the one you're with is your soulmate?
And so I walk into the kitchen and I see this. Look. Basically, Steve's parents arrived from the Philippines last night and dropped off one of Nathan's favourite type desserts. It's called puto. It's a Filipino like fairy cake, I want to say. It's like a cake type thing. My god, look, gave us a whole load. Apparently Steve's auntie baked it just before they got on the flight, so she was up at 2 a.m. baking all for Nathan. You know, he's such a prince. Morning. Lan's here, so I'm making us breakfast. I'm making us an omelette with mushrooms, spring onions, and I've got bacon cooking in the oven. Just having breakfast. Say hi, Lan.
No.
Say hi, Lan.
My makeup face.
Maybe you've got to pay attention to what you're doing.
Can't watch TV.
Smile for me, each stoke smiling for dad. Should you on top of it? Okay, cobbled it. You stand up again. Stand up. Stand up. Yay. Please smile. That's not a smile. Please watch up. Please watch up. Sorry. That is hairy.
Hi everyone, look at my little bear. We're just in the car waiting for Nathan. Steve's off today, so it was a really relaxing day for me. I got to have a shower and take my time and not have to worry about, you know, listening out for the baby crying and stuff. It was really relaxing. It's lovely having him around. So Steve's just gone to pick up Nathan from school, and then we're going to Steve's parents' house for dinner, because as I said earlier, they've just arrived back from the Philippines. Before I go there, I'm going to treat myself to a manicure. I never get to do my nails. There's just no chance. I just about managed to paint one nail, and then I have to move or wash my hands, and it just doesn't happen. So I'm just gonna get my nails done.
Yeah. Ah. Okay, all right, look, let's do that. All right. You need to burp, sweetheart. You haven't burped yet.
She hasn't slept all day. She's been, Steve's had her, and he's just been playing with her. So, she's been away the whole time. She's 1 month old today, guys. That 1 month went so quickly, didn't it? I can't believe it. Oh, here's Nate.
Hi, Nate.
How was your day?
Good.
Hey, guys. I hope I'm in focus because I'm using my big camera. I noticed in the last vlog when I was using my big camera, I was out of focus. Anyway, I'm back home now and got my nails done. Totally won't focus. So I got it in a neutral colour. If you can see, it's an OPI nail polish in Tenacious Spirit. I like it.
Mum, where are my PJs?
I might actually buy it for myself. I'm really liking this nude colour. Oh, while we're talking nude, let me show you this lipstick. I've got it on my lips now, if you can see. It's another neutral colour. And I've been loving this shade. This is what I've been using on a daily basis because it's just so easy to wear. It's by Gosh and it's dirt cheap. I can't even remember. It must be like £2-3 at most. And it's a matte shade because I'm still feeling my matte lipsticks. And it's in the shade 003 Antique. Let me see if you can see that. It's like my lips but better, but more on the brownie side. Let me see if I can. Ooh, love it. And even though it's a matte shade, it's quite creamy on your lips. I don't find it drying at all. Can you see that shade? Hope it's focusing. It's lovely. So if you're looking for a neutral shade, neutral everyday shade, try this out. It's gorgeous. I've had such a nice relaxing day today because Steve was off, and I think I've told you this already. Yeah, I had a good day today. I just wish he was at home more often. Anyway, if I don't speak to you again, good night for now.
Bubby, it's like you're about to turn over. What are you looking at? You're looking at the telly. You're too young to watch telly. Oh. Yeah, say hi. Say hi.
You playing with your toy?
And at the moment, I really have a thing for sweet potato fries. It's so easy. I just chop them up and toss them around in olive oil and a bit of salt, and then I chuck them in the oven. They're so good. It's morning. It's a beautiful sunny day today. I'm just out and about with Chloe. We're gonna go to the supermarket to get a few bits. Gonna go and visit a friend this morning because she needs a bit of cheering up. What should we talk about today? Can we talk about soulmates? How do you know that the one you're with is your soulmate? Or how do you know whether that person is still out there waiting for you or looking for you, you know? We're going deep this morning, aren't we? It's a toughie. Sometimes you're with your partner for years and go through the motions, you go for your daily bits, you work, you go out, you know, you just carry on with life, and then, you know, 10 years down the line, do you sit down and think, right, are you actually my soulmate? Are we meant to be together? Are we destined to be together? Like, how do you know that? You know, I read something on Facebook this morning, you see, which has triggered all this deep discussion. And it basically said your soulmate is someone that brings out the better person in you. You support each other. Let me see if I can find it and I'll read it. I have to use my phone to keep the camera propped up. Here you go. What is a soulmate? It's like a best friend, but more. That's so true. It's the one person in the world who knows you better than anyone else.
Whoa.
I totally need a camera stand. Listen, camera, I'm trying to be deep with my online friends. And you're messing up the whole thing. Let me park up safely before I talk to you. I guess it's probably just as bad as being on your mobile and driving. Okay, serious talk. See you there so you can see me. So that's someone who makes you a better person. No, actually, they don't make you a better person. You do that by yourself because they inspire you. A soulmate is someone you carry with you forever. It's one person who knew you, accepted you, and believed in you before anyone else did, or when no one else would. And no matter what happened, you'll always love them, and nothing could ever change that. Let that sink in. You might not end up with your soulmate throughout your whole entire life. Someone may have entered your life and that was your soulmate, and then for whatever reason you had to separate. Deep talk, man. Deep talk for 10 a.m. on a Wednesday morning. Is it Wednesday today? Here we go again. Yeah, let's just say no, it's Thursday. Yes, Thursday. Ugh. Right, I'm going in now. I'll see you guys in a bit. So I just left the supermarket and I must have bought a bottle of wine, yeah? And I got out to the checkout counter and I needed authorization from someone. And she must have walked up and looked at me and went, yeah, you look old enough. I was like, damn, bizarch. I was like, what do you mean? I was secretly hoping she was gonna ask me for my ID. I was like all ready to get it out and stuff. I might as well leave that ID at home. Look how colourful our dinner is tonight. God, I'm so proud of this. This is another new recipe that I found online. It's pan-seared cod on a bed of cubed potatoes with chorizo, spinach and peppers. God, I'm quite proud of that. That looks like restaurant quality, didn't it? Done it. Morning, happy Friday. Another beautiful day in London. Well, I say London, Greater London is what we're classed as. We're out Brighton early this morning, closing the back, asleep. Just dropped Nathan off to school and now we're heading out to do a bit of food shopping. Had a good day yesterday. It was so nice to catch up with a friend of mine who I rarely get to see. It was just nice in general to be out and about. I think you need that, you know, when you've just had a baby, it's so easy to stay at home and, you know, do the baby stuff, the feeds, the changing, etc., and just not do anything else because you're tired. But I find that if, you know, you go out for a walk or if you do something where you leave the house, it makes me feel so much better, you know. It makes me feel like a little bit more myself. You know, you do your face, you get changed out of your gym jams, you go out, you do stuff, and I don't know, my day just feels so much better. Something I've been talking to my girlfriends about recently, who also have kids and the ones that don't, is that when you have a baby, whether it be your first or your second or third, there's always books or articles. We always read that kind of stuff on preparing for having a baby, you know, like what to expect, what to do, all the rest of it. You never actually read up on stuff on how to keep your relationship healthy after you have a baby. So because it's my second child now and I kind of know what I'm doing and all the rest of it, it's not as challenging as the first time round. This time round, I'm actually working on my relationship with Steve. I read this article and it says how a large proportion of couples' relationships, like the quality of their relationships, decline once you have a baby. You know, you're sleep deprived, you're cranky, you tend to have more arguments, feelings of resentment, you know, the whole, oh, I'm doing more than you are at home with the household chores and stuff. Obviously, there's always been chores to do before you have a baby, but with a baby, it's like the workload increases, you know? And if you're like me and you're at home all day whilst your partner goes to work, you get lumbered with all the new baby chores to do. I think it's challenging. It's more challenging to be at home with a new baby than being at work. When you're at work, you know what you're doing, you know, and you get to have a break and you get to do things at your own pace when you want to do it. But when you have a baby, when you're at home, it's not in your own time anymore. It's in your baby's time. You know, like the other day, it was really hard because I couldn't have a meal without being interrupted, you know, because she wasn't going to sleep. And I couldn't go to the toilet without being interrupted. You lose a bit of your freedom. It's true what they say, when you have a baby, you also have to work on your relationship with your other half. We failed the first time around because we said, right, we're going to have date night once a month. That never happened. It was just so easy to stay at home with Nathan. But this time around, it doesn't have to be like a big date night, like eating out in a restaurant or going to see a movie. You can actually, you know, when the kids are asleep, you can stay at home, watch a film together, get a takeout, do you know what I mean? Just spend quality time. That's something that I want to work on. I so need to get a camera mount, a car mount for the car. You totally fell on the floor, I'm so sorry. And because I was busy talking too much, I drove to the wrong bloody supermarket. Oh God. Anyway, let me just quickly finish what I'm saying, then I'll concentrate on driving. Another thing that I'm going to work on is it's so easy to, you know, give your new baby all the attention and all your energy and, you know, all your affection that you forget to show your partner affection. So this time around, this is what I'm doing, you know, little gestures of affection, you know, whether it be, you know, a little kiss on the cheek or a little stroke of the arm, all the rest of it. So that is what I'm trying to do with my other half. And just taking time out, even if it's 2 or 5 minutes, taking time out to talk, you know, talk about stuff like, how's your day? You know, talk about stuff that's not baby related, not to do with the household, just general stuff. It could be about work or something you saw in the news or about friends. Do you know what I mean? That is what I'm trying to do. And it's little steps like that that I think would help our relationship. So on that note, I'm going to concentrate and drive to the right supermarket. I'll see you in a bit.
So on my list of things to do today is working on our wedding website. I want to add another page called Things to Do in Mexico, just to help our guests out, you know, give them something to look forward to and give them ideas of activities to do when they get out to Cancun.
Oh dear, she's hungry. We just got in and I've literally just taken her out of her car seat and put her on her changing mat, and I knew she was gonna wake up. She loves it in her car seat. Oh dear. Okay, milky time.
I'm gonna try and have some breakfast. I'm so starving. I really want, you know, those poached egg container thingies. So when I cook my eggs, I can have pretty shaped eggs. Did I ever show you our wedding invitations? I'm so pleased with them. It was, when they arrived, I was like, oh my God, that's exactly how I wanted them. This is my favorite bit. It's our initials WordPressed into the card. I don't know if you can see, but I love that. And all the text has been WordPressed as well. And I know you can't see it on film, but it comes with a good quality envelope as well. And I got these invitations in the colour ivory. And I really wanted to give the printing company or the stationery company a shout out. They're called Artcadia, and I'll put details of their website somewhere. Really pleased. Customer service was excellent. Like, they get back to you straight away when you have a question. I think the prices are really reasonable as well. The invitation plus the envelopes, VAT and delivery worked out to be about £4 per invite. So yeah, so pleased with them.
Anyway, I'm going to end this vlog now. I know I've been really crap at ending vlogs, but I'm going to say goodnight. I'm going to get ready for my night shift. By the time this is uploaded, you would have had your weekend. But anyway, I just hope you all had a good weekend. Get ready for Monday, all pumped up, ready to go, ready to start the week. And I'll see you in the next one. Good night. Bye.
How satisfying is that?
Amazing.